Welcome to Learning with Prep Class. I am BC. I am a Prep Class tutor. In this video, I'll be solving questions 41 to question 45 of the Loyola Jesuit College Entrance Examination Quantitative Reasoning Material 4. Please subscribe to our channel if you haven't done so, okay? Also, make sure that you like and comment on this video as I'll be happy to respond to your comments in the comment section. Thank you. Alright, so we have a set of samples to study. Study the sample below carefully and use it to find the missing numbers in the questions that follow. So this is very, very, very easy. So all we have to do here is to study the samples and use it to answer the questions. Remember, quantitative reasoning is a measure of a person's ability to use mathematical skills to solve problems. So you have to study the samples, find out the math necessary behind it, and then use it to answer the questions. As simple as that. All right, so here now, there are three numbers in each sample. And these three numbers, there is a relationship between them, okay? So we have to find out the relationship between these three numbers for us to be able to answer the question. Okay, so for this set of samples, all you have to do is to find the square of the sum of the top numbers. Okay, to get the bottom number. So this is what I mean. Add the two top numbers. Then when you get the answer, square it. What does square mean? The square of a number is the value that is obtained when the number is multiplied by itself. So the square of 2 is 2 times 2, which is 4. The square of 4 is 4 times 4, which is 16, right? Okay, so to get the bottom numbers here, all you have to do is to add the two top numbers. And then square the answer, that is whatever sum you get, multiply by itself to get the bottom number. So let's start with the first sample. 11 and 8 are the top numbers. So 11 plus 8 is 29. So 29 squared, that is 29 multiplied by 29. Let's do that here. 9 times 9 is 81. So write 1 and carry 8. 9 times 2 is 18. 18 plus 8 is 26, so write it here. Then 2 times 9 is 18, write 8 and carry 1. 2 times 2 is 4, 4 plus 1 is 5. Then add these numbers. 1 plus nothing is 1, 6 plus 8 is 14, write 4, carry 1. 1 plus 2 is 3, 3 plus 5 is 8. So this means that 29 multiplied by 29 is 841. So can you see that that's the answer here? Wow, we got it right. Okay, so let's look at the second sample as well. So the top numbers are 13 and 17. 13 plus 17 is 30. So all we have to do now is to do 30 squared. So 30 multiplied by 30. 0 times 0 is 0. 0 times 3 is 0. 3 times 0 is 0. Then 3 times 3 is 9. So let's add up this number. 0 plus nothing is 0. 0 plus 0 is 0. Then 9 plus nothing is 9. So can you see here that the bottom number is 900? Okay, so let's see the third sample now. If it works with the third sample, then we can go ahead to the question. Okay, so the top numbers here are 13 and 3. So let's add them. 13 plus 3 is 16. Then now we have to do 16 squared. That's 16 multiplied by 16. 6 multiplied by 6 is 36. So write 6 and carry 3. 6 multiplied by 1 is 6 plus 3, that is 9. Then 1 multiplied by 6 is 6. 1 multiplied by 1 is 1. So now, let's add it up. 6 plus nothing is 6. 9 plus 6 is 15. Write 5, carry 1. 1 plus 1 is 2. So can you see here that the bottom number is 256? Yes, we got it right. So this means that we can go ahead and answer the questions. So all we have to do now is to simply add the two top numbers. Then when you get your answer squared, that is multiply the answer by itself. As simple as that. Okay, so let's start with the first question in this video, question 41. So we have 7 and 6 as the top numbers, okay? So remember, all we have to do is to add the two top numbers and then square it. So that is why it is bottom number equals sum of top numbers squared, okay? So 7 plus 6 is what? 13. Then now we have to do 13 squared. Remember, the square of a number is the number multiplied by itself. Okay, so let's do 13 multiplied by 13 here. 3 times 3 is 9. 3 times 1 is 3. 1 times 3 is 3. 1 times 1 is 1. Then let's add it together. 9 plus nothing is 9. 3 plus 3 is 6. Then 1 plus nothing is 1. So this means that the answer is 169. So the bottom number here is 169. Can you see that? That's very easy. Okay, so the correct option here is A, 169. Check. Now to the next question, question 42. We're given just one of the top numbers. The second top number is missing. And then we're given the bottom number as well. Okay, so do you remember that to get the bottom number, all you have to do is to sum up the top numbers and then square it. Okay? But here, we're given the bottom number already. We have to find the top number. So to get the missing top number, we'll find the square root of the bottom number and then subtract the given top number from the answer. Okay? So square root of bottom number minus given top number. Okay? So the bottom number is 100. So square root of 100 minus given top number, which is 6. So to find the square root of 100 now, okay, so this is very easy, actually. So I'm going to be teaching you a very quick method of finding the square root of any number at all. So I'm going to be using the prime factorization method to find the square root of 100. So step one is to reduce 100 to its prime factors. I hope you still remember what prime numbers are. So prime numbers are numbers that are only divisible by themselves and 1. Okay, so let's reduce 100 to its prime factors. Okay, so let's do that here. 100 divided by 2 is 50. 50 divided by 2 is 25. 25 divided by 5 is 5. 5 divided by 5 is 1. So can you see that all of these numbers are prime numbers? Okay, so prime factors are the prime numbers that you multiply together to get the number. When you do 2 times 2 times 5 times 5, you will get 100. So 2 times 2 times 5 times 5 are the prime factors of 100. Okay, so now the second step is to group the digits in pairs. Pairs means 2. Put 2 in one group. Okay, then write only one of each pair and multiply. Okay, so 2 times 2 can be put in one group, then 5 times 5 can be put in another group. Okay, so write just one of the pairs. So you have 2 and you have 5 here. Okay, so 2 multiplied by 5 is 10. So this means that the square root of 100 is 10. I hope you got that. So for you to be sure that your answer is right, remember square root is opposite of square, right? So now multiply 10 by 10, you will get 100. So that's how you're sure that the square root is correct. Okay, we are still not true. Remember, all what we're trying to do is square root of 100 minus 6. Then the square root of 100 is what now? 10. Okay, so 10 minus 6 is 4. So the missing number is 4. Now, to be sure that the answer is correct, remember that from the options, all we have to do is to add the two top numbers, then square the answer to get the bottom number. So the missing number here is 4. 4 plus 6 is 10. 10 squared is 100. Yes, we got it right. Okay, so which of the options is correct? Option A is the correct option because 4 is the answer. Okay, question 43 now. So this is similar to the one we just did now. Okay, so we're given just one of the top numbers and then also the bottom number. But one of the top numbers is missing. So let's find it. Okay, remember, missing top number is equal to the square root of bottom number minus given top number. The bottom number is 289. So square root of 289 minus 4, which is the given top number. Okay, so now let's find the square root of 289 using the same prime factorization method. So step one is to reduce 289 to its prime factors. So 289 is only divisible by 17. If you try dividing 289 by 2, 3, 5, 7, 11, if you try that, you're going to be getting decimal numbers, and we don't want decimal numbers. Okay? So 289 divided by 17 is 17. 17 is also only divisible by 17 and 1. Okay, so 17 divided by 17 is 1. So this means that the prime factors of 289 are 17 times 17. Okay, so step 2 is to group the digits in pairs and write only one of each pair. Okay, so we have only one pair here. So we're going to write just 17. So 17 and 17, we write just 17. So this means that the square root of 289 is 17. If you multiply 17 by itself, that is 17 multiplied by 17, you will get 289. So this means that the square root is correct. Okay, so now, square root of 289 minus 4. is now 17 minus 4. 17 minus 4 is 13. So the missing number is 13. Now let's see if it's correct. So 13 plus 4 is 17. Then 17 squared is 289. So we got this correctly as well. So the correct option here is D, 13. Check. Question 44. So we're given just one of the top numbers. And then the bottom number is also given. And we're asked to find the missing top number. So we're going to be doing exactly what we did in question 43 and question 42. Okay, so missing top number is equal to square root of bottom number minus given top number. So the bottom number is 361. So square root of 361 minus 3. So to find the square root of 361, using the prime factorization method, step one is to reduce 361 to its prime factors. So 361 is only divisible by 19. So 361 divided by 19 is 19. Then 19 divided by 19 is 1. So this means that the prime factors of 361 is 19 times 19. If you multiply 19 by 19, you will get 361. Okay, so step two is to group the digits in pairs and write only one of each pair. Okay, so you can get only one pair here. So let's write just one of it, which is 19. So this means that the square root of 361 is 19. To be sure that your answer is correct, multiply 19 by 19. If you get 361, then we are right. So now the square root of 361 minus 3 equals 19 minus 3. 19 minus 3 is 16. So the missing number here is 16. If you add 16 and 3 together, you get 19. Then 19 squared is 361. So yes, we got it right. Okay, so which of the following options is correct? Option C is the correct option because the answer is 16. Check. Now to the final question in this video. So we're given one of the top numbers as 16. The second top number is missing. And then the bottom number here is 1089. So let's do this now. So missing top number is equal to square root of bottom number minus given top number. Okay? Then the bottom number is 1089, right? So square root of 1089 minus the given top number, which is 16. So we have to find the square root of 1089. So the step one is to reduce 1089 to its prime factor. So let's do that here. 1089 divided by 3 is 363. 363 divided by 3 is 121. Then 121 is only divisible by 11. Okay, so 121 divided by 11 is 11. Then 11 divided by 11 is 1. Okay, so now the prime factors of 1089 is 3 times 3 times 11 times 11. Okay, now let's move on to step two. Step two, we are to group the digits in pairs and write only one of each pair and multiply them. So let's put 3 times 3 in a pair, then 11 times 11 as another pair. Okay, then write only one of each pair, 3 and 11. So 3 multiplied by 11 is 33. So this means that the square root of 1089 is 33. Wow! So when you multiply 33 by itself, that is 33 multiplied by 33, you would get 1089. So you can see that that is very easy. Now we have the square root of 1089 as 33 now. So we want to do square root of 1089 minus 16. So now we have 33 minus 16. 33 minus 16 can be done here. 3 minus 6 is not possible. So we get 1 here. And then this remains 2. Then this is now 13. 13 minus 6 is 7. Then 2 minus 1 is 1. So the answer is 17. So this means that the missing number is 17. For you to be sure that the answer is correct, add the top numbers, 16 and 17. That would give 33, right? Then 33 squared would give 1089. Yes, so this means that we got it right. So which of the following options is correct? The correct option here is option C. Check, because the answer is 17. Okay, so I hope you enjoyed this video and you're able to learn a lot from this. Please subscribe to our channel, like and comment on this video as well to get more videos like this. Okay, till I come your way next time. Bye.